Do you guys remember when the metaverse was all the rage? While Meta hasn't really gained traction with its Horizon platform, there is an existing community of over 70 million that hangs out daily on Roblox.
Roblox launched in 2006, and yet, even today, many observers misunderstand the platform. So we're here to give you the full rundown on how Roblox works and why its financials are misleading if you don't look closer.
Yes, so we're gonna peel back the layers today and analyze what sets Roblox apart, how Roblox makes money, recent business highlights, and what to keep an eye on. So stay tuned. I'm Stephanie, tech veteran, engineer, and creator.
And I'm Bertrand, founder of App Economy Insights. For those unfamiliar, Roblox isn't your typical game. It's a sprawling metaverse, a persistent virtual world where millions of users can socialize, play games, and even create their own experiences. But metaverse has been a wildly overused word in the past few years.
Right, but Matthew Ball has a great definition on this. The metaverse is persistent, synchronous and live, unlimited in the number of users, a fully functioning economy, an experience that spans both the digital and physical worlds, cross-platform, cross-play, populated by user-generated content and experiences. Roblox has all of these traits, but it's critical to note that it's not really a game. Instead, it's a platform that connects users and creators.
Here's what truly sets Roblox apart. It's not built by internal studios. Roblox thrives on a constant stream of user-generated content, or UGC for short. Just like creators making videos on YouTube, Roblox users design the experiences on the platform and they can monetize their content. This approach fuels Roblox growth with fresh, ever-evolving content, fostering a powerful network effect. Because of this focus on UGC, Roblox is more like YouTube and less like Fortnite. And over half of US kids under 16 were on Roblox in 2020, and the audience has continued to grow since then, nearly 72 million daily active users in Q4 2023.
Roblox has its own virtual currency called Robux. Users buy Robux with real money and spend it on all sorts of things, in-game items, accessories for their avatars, or access to exclusive experiences. Developers earn a share of the Robux spent on the experiences that they offer, which they can then use on the platform or exchange for real-world currency at an exchange rate defined by the company. In December 2023, over 5 million developers and creators earned Robux on the Roblox platform, earning over $700 million in annual payout.
Management shares three key business metrics you should know. Daily active users, or DAUs, those who log in on a given day. It indicates the overall size of the audience on Roblox, and it grew 22% year-over-year to 72 million in Q4 of 2023. Next, we have hours engaged. It's the time spent by users on the platform, and it's basically the North Star for management. It grew 21% year-over-year to more than 15 billion hours. And bookings, finally, is the dollar amount spent on the platform by users, and bookings grew 25% year-over-year to over $1 billion. Management also tracks the average booking per daily active users, or app DAU for short, it's a mouthful, but it reflects spending trends at the user level, and it declined slightly by 3% year-over-year to roughly $16.
This visual shows where each dollar spent on Roblox goes. So you have App Store fees, which is about 23%. It's processing payment fees on operating systems like iOS, Android, or Xbox. Then we have developer share, which is about 30%. Developer earnings based on Robux spent on their experiences or engagement-based payouts. Next, we have platform hosting and support, about 22%. This is maintenance of the servers, customer experience, moderation, and acquisition. We also have platform investment, which is about 16%. And this is all the ongoing research and development. And then finally, Roblox's share is about 9%. So this is what's left for Roblox before paying for ongoing services and operating costs.
So when a user spends Robux, it's not necessarily reflected as immediate revenue for the company. Some items, like virtual clothes, are considered durable, meaning you can use them for a long time in the game. So Roblox recognizes that revenue gradually over the lifetime of a paying user, which is currently around 28 months. This is why bookings are a leading indicator They show future revenue trends, and revenue is a lagging indicator. It takes time to catch up to bookings. In fact, some of the revenue trails bookings by over 2 years. Before we talk about whether Roblox is as profitable as you might think, yes, we are going to ask, smash that subscribe button.
Look, it might not seem like a lot, but it really helps our videos be discovered, and it's how we keep bringing you more tech, investing, and business content.
Roblox ended the year with their strongest rate of quarterly bookings growth in 2 years and delivered again their first quarter with over 1 billion in bookings.
Users over 13 grew 28% year over year, which is much faster than the overall audience, and it represented 58% of the user base. So this confirms that the audience is sticking around. Evidence shows that the platform is aging up. The paying conversion is also at an all-time high, with nearly 16 million users spending money monthly, which is roughly $20 on average.
So in short, Roblox is firing on all cylinders. Daily active users are climbing, engagement is high, and bookings are growing fast.
Meanwhile, the company is reporting huge losses, but it's not actually as bad as it looks. First, let's take a look at the gross margin. The headline number, 77% in Q4, looks impressive, but keep in mind it excludes expenses like server upkeep and developer fees, making it seem higher than reality. So a more accurate estimate suggests a gross margin closer to 40%. Next, the operating margin. This is negative and getting worse. Revenue is spread out over time, but the costs actually hit the P&L right away. They reported $1.2 billion in losses for the year compared to $900 million in losses the prior year.
So the gross and operating margin don't reflect the full potential of the business because they don't account for that deferred revenue over time. That said, adjusted margins, which are provided by management, they are misleading too because they exclude stock-based compensation, making profitability seem better than it actually is. If we factor in the deferred revenue without excluding stock-based compensation, Roblox is basically just breaking even. To be sure, Roblox has a solid balance sheet with a net cash position of over $2 billion in FY23, and free cash flow was $124 million compared to an outflow of $58 million in FY22. While Roblox is generating positive operating cash flow, it's primarily thanks to its heavy use of SBC. And as a result, although the sustainability of the business is not at risk right now, existing shareholders are facing steady dilution in the near term.
The underlying technology and infrastructure of Roblox is composed of three elements. So first, we have the Roblox client. This is that free app that you use to explore the 3D world, whether you're on your phone or your computer. We have the Roblox studio. This is the secret sauce for creators. It's a free toolkit that lets anyone design, publish, and run their own 3D experiences on Roblox. And of course, the Roblox cloud, a massive network of over 100,000 servers that power the entire platform.
In their 2023 Roblox annual developer conference, they made several big announcements. First, a new focus on creation with generative AI into Roblox Studio. This includes an AI assistant called, well, Assistant, that can help creators with repetitive tasks and tools that can automatically generate 3D models and textures based on user input. The main goal for Roblox is to empower everyone to become a creator through accessible tools to unlock even more content on the platform.
They also talked about improved monetization for creators. So Roblox listened to feedback from its creator community, and they announced plans to give creators 100% of the net proceeds from the sale of their assets and tools on the creator marketplace. Well, minus taxes and fees. But this is going to give them higher payouts to help build a more vibrant community.
They are expanding to new devices like PlayStation consoles or the Meta Quest. They want to be essentially a universal app the same way YouTube is.
And Roblox is dabbling in immersive ads. Early results show creators, especially those less established, earning up to a 20% boost from these ads. Brands like H&M are also reaping benefits with increased engagement and new audience reach. One H&M ad even drove thousands of organic visits thanks to its interactive nature.
So overall, the potential for Roblox is undeniable. It has the chance to become a dominant player in the metaverse, a market projected to be worth trillions in the coming decades. However, It's a long-term play. Investors need to be comfortable with the inherent risks, notably competition is fierce for attention, and profitability remains uncertain. More importantly, dilution could play against existing shareholders. By the time Roblox hits its strides financially, it may face a rising competitive environment, particularly due to AI, lowering the barrier to entry in game development.
Now, in our next video, we visualize the 10 largest companies by gaming revenue. Microsoft is shaking up the industry with its recent acquisitions, so see you right there.